Wellness for Life is brought to you by Back in Motion Physical Therapy, Gothenburg Chiropractic Clinic, Mahabi Atwa Community Action Partnership, Lakeside Sports and Pain Clinic, and Thomas and Swanson and Zahn Attorneys at Law.
Hello, my name is Sarah Swanson, and I am an attorney at the Thomas and Swanson and Zahn Law Firm in Park Rapids. At our law firm, we practice a wide array of practice areas, but particularly what we want to share about today is in our elder law and estate planning section of our practice. Our office employs a geriatric care manager, Laurel Haid. A geriatric care manager is a licensed social worker or nurse, and in our case, Laurel is a social worker, and she has been specifically trained as a geriatric care manager. She has received specific coursework and experience in assisting elderly clients in managing just the various transitions that come with moving into a new home setting, medical issues that arise, dealing with family issues, and a wide array of other things that come up as people move into the elderly stages of life. We like to call Laurel our adopted daughter, and her services can include anything that your children might ordinarily help you with. If they're not available, Laurel can do that. And she has a wealth of experience and knowledge. Particularly, what we want to share with you today about is entering the hospital. It sounds like such a simple situation, but really can be so overwhelming, especially because someone is sick. Laurel is going to share with you just an overview, but the important things to remember and keep in mind as you are getting admitted into the hospital. Laurel?
Well, it's really important to be prepared for those unexpected medical emergencies, and so this topic is titled Hospital 101. There's two kinds of illnesses that we could have. One is called chronic illness. And with chronic illness, what that means is it lasts 3 months or longer. An example of a chronic illness is congestive heart failure, or CHF, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, which is COPD, Alzheimer's disease, is just to name a few. Acute illness is the second kind of illness that we can have. And that generally is an abrupt onset, short duration, rapidly progressive, and in need of urgent care at times. Examples of acute illness is something as simple as a sore throat or a heart attack or a stroke, trauma. So these are situations that we generally end up calling an ambulance for. And when you call an ambulance for any of these situations, you want to make sure you have things prepared in your mind, so pre-plan. What would you say to the operator when you call the ambulance? You want to let them know what's wrong. You want to know, where are you? Are you in the backyard, in the garage, in the house? Is your door unlocked? Is there animals in the house that they need to be aware of? You also are going to want to include your name, your address, your age. Once you're in the emergency room, the staff is going to want to know your medication list. They're going to want to know who to contact. Who's your emergency contact person? What is your primary doctor's name? Do you have any kind of end-of-life choices that you've thought about? So those are things that you want to be prepared for when you're in the emergency room. And then once they have done the testing and made a determination of whether you're going to return home or not, the chances are you may end up having to stay in the hospital. So you're going to want to ask, are you an inpatient in the hospital, or are you going to be admitted for observation? Discharge planning will start on day one. You may return home with home care services in place after your stay in the hospital, or you may be transferred to a skilled nursing facility for continued therapy and nursing care. If you are going to be transferred to a nursing home, that's when you want to specifically know if you've been an inpatient or observation. Because if you're Medicare eligible, you need a 3-day inpatient hospital stay to be able to have Medicare help you pay for those bills that you would have at the nursing home. So you want to make sure to request to speak to a financial worker if you have any concerns about your bill paying or Medicare payment for a nursing home stay.
Great. Laurel, is this something that you can assist clients with in your role as a geriatric care manager?
Absolutely. This is something that we could sit down together, and there's numerous different forms that could be filled out and put on your refrigerator. And when the EMTs come in, that's the first place they look to see if there's any kind of direction for them as to what your needs are and what they can do for you. So I would love to be able to be part of that pre-planning and preparing for those unexpected medical emergencies.
Great. Thank you, Laurel. If you have any questions about this topic, anything related to geriatric care management or estate planning, we would love to help you out. Please give our office a call.
Thank you for watching Wellness for Life. Brought to you by Back in Motion Physical Therapy, Gothenburg Chiropractic Clinic, Mahabi Atwa Community Action Partnership, Lakeside Sports and Pain Clinic, and Thomas and Swanson and Zahn Attorneys at Law.